Today's video is about the trainer difficulty setting within Zwift, the most asked about and the least understood setting within Zwift. There's more to it than just going uphill. Now, before I get to the details of this video, be sure to hit subscribe on this channel. It really helps it out and helps me keep producing content like this. Okay, onto the details and the trainer difficulty slider or the setting within Zwift. What you need to know is the trainer difficulty slider or difficulty setting has no impact here in game. It's only what is sent to your smart bike or smart trainer in regard to the gradient. So for example, in Zwift, if my trainer slider was set to maximum and on screen it said 10%, then that's what Zwift sends to my smart bike or smart trainer. It will simulate a 10% gradient. Now, if I was to set that slider to halfway, such as 50%, the trainer difficulty, in-game, no change whatsoever. The avatar still has to ride up a 6% grade. However, what Zwift sends to the trainer, or the smart bike, is halved, so I only feel a 3% climb. However, there's more to it than that, and the downhill is a little different. By default, Zwift will send only half of the negative gradient to the smart bike or the smart trainer, and that's when the slider is at maximum. So if I was riding down a negative 10% gradient, Zwift will only send negative 5 to the smart bike or the smart trainer. If my trainer difficulty setting was 50% or halfway, things get a little trickier. Zwift first halves that value, so negative 10% becomes negative 5% sent to the trainer. And that's halved again based on my user preferences. So what happens there is a negative 10% gradient with a 50% slider means I only feel negative 2.5% here on the smart bike or the smart trainer. But do remember, in game, the avatar doesn't know any different. He's still flying down negative 10%. Okay, so that's the theory of how the trainer difficulty setting works both uphill and a little differently downhill. Let's put that into practice. What I've got here is the kicker bike with tilt. I've got the virtual tilt shown on screen, and below that, the physical tilt that the bike is being sent by Zwift. So as we go up the climb here with the maximum slider set, 6%, 7%, very close to it. So one for one, uphill, with the trainer difficulty setting to maximum or 100%. So 9, yep, very close, drops down a bit. Things get steeper around the corner here. 11, there we go. And you can see they're almost one for one with the virtual reality and the real reality here on the kicker bike. So, on the descent, what we should see is half of what we have on screen there simulated. Let's check it out. Okay, negative 7, bike, negative 3.5. There we go, confirmation on that one. That Zwift halves the negative gradient when the maximum trainer difficulty is on. There we go. Negative 3.5, 3.6, and down to the flat. So there we are, confirmation of the theory and how things work with maximum trainer difficulty enabled. Let's go set that to half and see how it goes up and quarter down. Okay, settings, trainer difficulty slider. Now it's not a perfect science, but I think that's close enough. Hit okay, back to the right. Exactly the same test as before with the same information on screen. The Zwift figure being what the avatar has to deal with, that doesn't change. And the figure below that is the kicker bike, which is what's being sent to the trainer or smart bike. 0-0, looking good. Okay, up we go. 6%, just over 3.5, there we go. It's halved, the figure sent to the trainer. Remembering the avatar still has to ride up that steep gradient. Nothing changes there. Okay, 10%, 5.5. Yep. And the turnaround, remembering Zwift will halve the gradient by default and then halve it based on my preference. So we'll turn around and the simulated descent sent to the trainer. There we go. That -2. Again, avatar doesn't change. My rider's still flying down that descent, but we have 1/4 of the descent simulation with the trainer slider set to half. So there we are. As the title of the video stated, the trainer difficulty slider, there's something more you need to know about the descents. Now this has been confirmed with Zwift, and we did confirm it there with what was sent through to the kicker bike, and it's the same for any other smart trainer. I believe this decision was made early on in Zwift's development process to halve the negative gradients. That's because on a big long descent, there's nothing to push against, and your avatar game speed is all about generating watts. There's also a lot of differences between how trainers deal with zero resistance sent to them. Some will let go of resistance altogether, some will still apply a little bit of resistance. So it kind of levels the playing field there. Could this be implemented any better way on Zwift for descents? Maybe. I think descending in a bunch could be based more on your positioning, maybe your bike handling if we had some steering. When it's based on watts, we need something to push against to determine who goes fast and who goes not as fast. Alrighty, wrapping this one up for today. Hopefully this has been informative and interesting. If so, remember, give it a thumbs up and hit subscribe to support this channel. Thanks for watching.